Well, I mean, I just don't see them as having lower status. I don't see them as embodying.
Put that in quote marks. Just
okay.
To, you know.
All right. I was like, I was with you for a second.
Well, Gina.
No, but look, yeah. Seriously, I get where yeah. you're going. I think that what I really want to do is to come to painting with a sense of empathy.
Yeah.
Because not everyone makes work that looks like this, because it's not everyone's experience that leads them to draw certain conclusions. And the conclusions that I draw with my work have to do with a desire to connect, rather than a desire to create a type of bombast for its own mm-hmm. sake. Sure, these paintings are designed to be highly decorative and sugary sweet to the point that they draw you in, and it's that sugar pill that allows you to see what's even further within that narrative. So much of what I try to do in my work is to really look at the language of body. This, back in the day, was considered to be the ways that someone in a Franz, this is, I believe, a direct reference from Franz Hals, this sort of Flemish notion of dignity and grace. But then how do we then transport black women's hairstyles from the 21st century into something that sort of becomes this morass, this Medusa-like coil that becomes its own stand-in for power today? I think that all of that stuff is fluid. The language of respect that you referred to mm-hmm. before is fluid. It requires a level of empathy that allows you to nod and to say yes and amen to the people who happen to look like you.
So look, you know, we're at the BFI, and I want to ask this question a bit. Yeah, how do you move from working as a painter, or why did you feel it was necessary to expand your practice into filmmaking?
Well, no one has time to pose for paintings anymore. Like, painting from life is out. But what we